Hello and welcome, grade 10 to 12 thinkers. You're nearly at the end of your high school career, and together we can make it successful and memorable. All your assessments can be found under the Assessments tab on your dashboard. There are different types of assessments, for example, tests, exams, tasks, orals, and PATs. All assessments have a due date, which must be strictly adhered to. Your tests and exams will only become available on the due date itself, and all other assessments are available long before, giving you ample time to complete them efficiently. When you open your assessment, it's best to download and print it so that you're able to complete it without any challenges. It's also a good idea to keep it filed for your records. The due dates here for your assessments are noted in your assessment calendar. That's your assessment calendar, which is located under the Termly Planners and Notices Content tab. We encourage you to print this calendar at the start of each term to avoid missing any important due dates. You're also encouraged to check your dashboard regularly for notices regarding any possible changes. How to complete assessments, tests, and exams. In order to complete your tests and exams, you will need an invigilator to be present. An invigilator can be any person who's not a family member and or is older than 21 years. They also need to complete and pass our short invigilation test, which is available under Termly Planners for Term 1. Please ensure that you've also carefully worked through all the important documentation found under this tab. It's important to remember that all tests and exams must be completed in pen using the Think Digital Answer Book, which can also be found under Termly Planners for Term 1. No typed test or exams will be accepted or considered, as they're not accepted by the exam board unless a special concession is granted. Please ensure that your pages are numbered as you go. An invigilator's report must also be submitted with each test and exam. This report can be submitted as page 2 of your script, following the cover page from the answer book. Tasks. Those are projects, assignments, practical tasks, or PAT tasks. Your tasks, which comprise of projects, assignments, practical tasks, and PAT tasks, can be completed in your own time. It's always a good idea to avoid procrastinating, start early, and plan them well. Because they are there early, you can do them in your own time. Oral tasks, prepared and unprepared speeches, prepared and unprepared reading. Now, you'll be required to make a video recording of you delivering oral tasks. You'll need to submit the video by this submissions page for assessing by our assessment team. You don't need to record this in the highest possible resolution. As long as we can clearly see and clearly hear you, we'll be able to assess. Please ensure that it's uploaded in MP4 format only. That's MP4 format only. How to submit assessments. Your completed assessments must be scanned and saved as a single PDF document and submitted to your submissions portal. Should your desktop scanner not be available, please use one of the many mobile scanning apps available in the various app stores. It's important to remember that any scripts that have been submitted in any other format, including Word documents or picture files, will not be accepted or assessed. You'll have to find these various tabs for all your assessments on this portal. To submit your script, you'll simply click on the Upload button and navigate to where you've saved your completed script on your device by clicking on the Choose File button. So first the Upload button, then the Choose File button. Once you've chosen the correct file, please click Submit to successfully upload the document to your submissions page. Please also ensure that your submission matches the submission name on the portal list. You can view your submitted scripts by clicking on the View and Resubmit button. Now, when submitting your scripts, please ensure that you include all the pages of your script before scanning and uploading to the portal. That's all your pages. You fully completed the front page of your answer book. All your pages are numbered and in the correct order. All your pages are upright, not upside down or sideways, and that you viewed your scanned documents to ensure that it's legible, that we can read it. No scripts that have been emailed will be accepted or assessed. The secret here is to plan well and submit on time. Remember, those who fail to plan to fail. Our assessment process is monitored and moderated by the exam board to ensure that we adhere to all their regulations. For this reason, it's imperative that you complete your tests and exams on the specified dates. Should you be ill on the day, you'll need to provide us with a medical certificate which cannot be post-dated. Please upload your medical certificate under the applicable tab in place of your script. We understand that challenges may arise at times, for example, load shedding or poor internet connections. We therefore provide ample time before for you to complete and submit your assessments on time. We encourage you to submit your task early on the due date rather than just before the tab closes at 11 in the evening. It is the responsibility of you, the learner, to have a plan B in place, ensuring that you're able to complete and submit all your assessments on time, no matter what the extenuating circumstances. You'll also be able to view your mark script on your submissions portal under the relevant submission tab once the assessors have completed the marking process. Take careful note of comments and useful feedback given to you by your assessor. This will help you to identify any learning gaps that you may have, as well as guide you to which areas you should focus on in your learning going forward.